And tonight, Beer Goggles is going to be Tom Jones.
It's not unusual. Got a mouthful of air. Right. Let's dish round a bit, Dave.
Okay. Hey.
We're doing a review. Oh, isn't it?
Isn't it?
Of a Welsh beer. Listen, if I've offended anyone. Just in case I've offended anyone.
Yeah, any Bob Marley fans.
Well, any Tom Jones, oh, isn't it? Tom Jones fans.
Isn't it?
If I've offended any Tom Jones fans, I do mean from the, right from the bottom of my arse, I don't mean nothing by it, seriously. We've got, I'm going to take this off, I'm fucking sweating like a glass blows arse. Right, we've got a lovely one here, we've both got one each. From our mate Simon.
Yeah.
Was that you, Dave?
No, that was your chair.
That's the chair. From our mate Simon, fellow reviewer, superstar and legend. He is the Europe's biggest beer reviewer in Europe. Oh, yeah. I'll tease him about his t-shirt he had made up. But serious stuff. I tried it at the Beer Festival, GBBV, and it was quite nice. I liked it. It had a nice kind of nose, a nice aroma on it, you know. The mouthfeel, there was something strange. It was just something a little bit strange, but the taste were there as well, and it was a nice beer. Right.
Can I just say that, the version that I had, I think it might have been a bit off.
I think he might have had the bottom of the barrel, yeah, because he didn't have a nice one.
Nah, it was way too chemical.
I went back a bit later when they changed the barrel.
So I'm really excited to try the bottle.
You might have had one of Simon's socks in yours or something.
Yeah, I might
have
done, yeah.
It's treading the grapes in it, you know. Right, we've got a little sealed top, so I'm going to kind of,
6%.
Oh, you don't have to. We're talking, I haven't even showed you what it is. I'm going to read the gumph off this as well, because he is a fellow reviewer, and I like to see... I like to see when us guys are kind of being recognised for the effort we put in. I don't know if you do, but I don't see it as effort.
Not at all.
Because it's a passion. It's something we love doing.
Yeah.
But we do put a lot of time, a lot of effort into it. And sometimes you talk to some people and you go, you know, what do you reckon on social media and that, and its impact on business and brewing and stuff and the world. And they're like, oh, it's social media,
yeah.
You know, kind of poo-poo it almost. And I think it's lovely when someone like Brains, especially a big brewer like Brains, and a lovely brewer like Brains, recognises the facts of what we're doing, what we're trying to do, and that is promote good beer.
Yeah.
That being said, and as much as I tried it at the BBBF and GBBF, I should say, and enjoyed it. That being said, if it's poo, I will say it's poo, and if it's nice, I will say it's nice.
And you know, I will as well.
Yeah. So I'm going to read the gumph a little bit off of
it. I don't often read them, but it's kind of a special occasion, I think.
So we'll see how we go with it. Oh, you got yours as well?
I've got mine open, yeah.
Good lad. He's been doing something while I'm jabbering away, you know. That's the it looks a slate coloured. That's the crown there. I'm putting it up onto the bottle cap, Jenga, nothing's fell down. And I just should have been emptied, but there you go, I've been doing other reviews. Never mind.
This isn't bottle conditioned either.
It's not?
No. I thought it would be. But that,
well, what you say, that don't necessarily mean, look at the bottom of the glass, mate. The bottle.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, no smear at all.
No. But yeah, I mean, going back to the social media thing, I mean, we've been chatting to a few brewers about it, like Ewan from Harveston and that, and I think they're starting to recognise just exactly what us guys do.
That's the carbonation on here, sorry, Mark, by the way. Chat away, mate.
And, yeah, so basically, I'm just saying, I think it's an important role in promoting craft beer. I really do. blogging, vlogging, anything like that, anything to do with the internet, you know. And the sooner that the breweries realise this, I'm not saying this as like, you know, oh, look how important we are.
Yeah.
But the sooner they realise it, the sooner more people will know about these beers.
Well, you see the power of social media when you've only got to say riot and everyone riots and all that, you know.
Yeah.
And it's been used to good effect by people like Durham Brewery and things like that.
Yeah.
With their white stout, got loads of kind of... loads of media attention,
yeah.
But it kind of media attention. They often go down. Media itself often goes and looks on Twitter and looks on YouTube and looks on all sorts.
Mm.
But anyway, enough of that.
Yeah, let's get to the beer.
Right, let's have a sniff. Let's have just a twirl first. And yeah, you're getting nice fruity hops.
Yeah, it smells different to the cask that I had. I'm getting,
yeah, you must have had a dodgy cask, I think.
Yeah, I'm getting like a...
bottom of the barrel or something.
It's like a, almost like a sweet sort of cakey grapefruit. Almost like a, a pudding, a grapefruit pudding or sponge.
Yeah, but I'm getting the exact same thing, but with a little bit of peach in there. You know, little tiny dry bits of peach. I'm not getting the bouncy, chewy bits of peach. I'm getting little dry bits of peach in there, you know, dried fruits.
It's got a very sort of malty hoppiness to it.
Mm.
Very similar to like, one of my favourite IPAs, which is the Nugna 500. I don't think, well, I don't know. If it is as good as that, then I'm going to be Robin Simon for it.
Yes. Yep.
But it has got a really nice smell.
It smells almost Amarillo as well, isn't it?
Mm.
Maybe even Citra, but I'm kind of getting those sort of smells.
Yeah. I definitely think the cask version.
Even some of along the kind of Simcoe sort of lines and things like that.
Because this is it isn't as harsh as what I smelled at the festival. It smells really, really good.
Shall we dive in?
Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers, David.
Cheers.
Cheers, Simon.
Cheers, mate.
And cheers, everyone at Brains. Cheers, everyone everywhere. Cheers, guys.
Let's go.
Drink one, try one. Ooh. That's weird. That's really weird.
It's quite mild, isn't it? I thought it was going to be a lot more punchy.
But you're getting something weird in the malt sort of direction. I'm telling you what I'm getting. Salty cashews. Salty, quite kind of burnt cashews almost, but salty cashews.
Yeah, definitely a sort of nut.
Seriously. But
I'm getting those the malty sort of fruit notes coming through as well, but they're no way as intense as the nose.
If you ever got something cooking, you chop the nuts up, put them on top of something, and they get burnt up a little bit.
Almost like a sort of satay or something like that, like a peanut sort of satay sort of smell.
I don't know, but sometimes you put them on top of like baklavas and things and whatever else, just burn them up a little bit. It's kind of like that.
But It's very easy to drink, really, really easy to drink.
You're getting a dry background note as well, on kind of cleaning the mouth up.
Yeah.
This is really interesting because you're getting, I'm not recognising many dark fruits at the moment, but I'm getting toasted cashews, big time, big time. I'm getting a little hint of, small hints of kind of calm and Miranda mixed fruits. I'm getting kind of little hints of apricots in there. But dried fruits, dried apricot. Dried fruits, dried mixed fruits. I'm getting a little bit to... I just keep getting hit with these toasted cashews.
To be honest with you, I've never really sort of tried cashews, so...
No?
Nah. So I can't really get that.
Almost like a toasted peanut.
But I'm just getting quite a lot of malt. Like a fruity malt or something like that.
Yeah.
Not too much bitterness. I thought it was going to be a lot more bitter than this.
Yeah.
And it's very light. Very
Kind of Chardonnay dryness on the tongue.
Yeah.
Almost kind of that, like I've said before, I've only ever had that real dryness on the tongue from the beet hop. The kind of experimental Yakima or whatever is... The beta hop, B-E-A-T-A. You get that dry Chardonnay finish on it, and it's almost like that again.
I mean, using my base descriptions, I'm not as descriptive as you, because I haven't got that much knowledge.
No, you are.
But if I was to compare this to another beer, it would be the Nogno 500, but like a watered down version. It's very sessionable tasting.
I don't think I've had that one.
Nah, you need to try that. Once you've tried that, you're not. I'm on about. But yeah, it's very easy drinking.
I'm getting something butterscotchy as well, isn't it? Distant butterscotch, but it's almost buttering the tongue. I'm not talking diatoms and things like
that. No.
But that's it's almost buttering the tongue with like a rich sort of oily flavour.
That's what I was trying to describe, like a buttery sort of hoppiness.
Yeah.
Yeah. If I'm perfectly honest, it's not my favourite flavour, the butteriness.
Yeah.
But it's really, really easy to drink. And yeah, I'll definitely buy it again.
I think I disagree with that it's easy to drink.
Yeah?
I feel you'd want to sit down with this one because it is quite complex, but it's not for me, it ain't one of them first quenching going down. So you want to kind of sit down, watch the telly with this one and take your time and, you know, have a little chat with your mates and the boys and whatever, but take your time.
Yeah.
There's all sorts of weird and wonderful things in it.
I'd definitely say give it a go, just to give it a try and see what you think.
Tiny little bit of grapefruit, bit of pineapple. Yeah, it's interesting. It really is.
Buttery pineapple.
Yeah, buttery pineapple. When I say go out and buy it and try it, I would say buy it and try it.
Yeah.
Buy it, try it and like it. That's up to you. I kind of like it, but I think I wouldn't advise you doing it as a session beer. I would advise you kind of getting a small one like that in amongst your beer shop and, you know, going to Brains or wherever and trying all different ones out, but try that one out, as many of them.
The only thing I'm slightly disappointed with, I thought it was going to be a bit more fruitier.
It wasn't quite as fruity as the smell. That's one thing. But then the cashew just surprised me so much, and it was such a fresh new character, a fresh new taste. Then it was like, ooh! I did have that going on. I had a lovely kind of fresh taste, something brand new. And that was cool. It's not the hop bomb kind of thing that you expect.
Nah, not so.
But, and it's not, I wouldn't say it's a typical American style IPA.
Nah.
Because you'd expect a bigger, hoppier, more resinous character. But this was something really strange, really nice. I kind of, I think you've got to buy it and try it.
I like the fact that it is called Barry Island IPA, because I suppose you could associate it as a style.
Yeah.
This is what a Barry Island IPA tastes like. Not an American IPA, not an English IPA.
Exactly.
It's a Barry Island IPA.
Yeah.
So fair enough, if that's what Barry Island IPA tastes like, then fair play to it.
That's cool, yeah.
Yeah. But I think it doesn't
taste of an American IPA. But I still like it. Yeah. So, chin chin.
Cheers.
Buy it, try it. I think you might like it.
Yeah.
But I think it's going to be people sitting on the fence with that one.
Bit of a Marmite one.
Yeah, yeah. Because it's kind of peanutty. Yeah. It's like smooth peanut butter in it. Anyway, we're gone. 15 minutes, 16 minutes nearly in with that one.
Blimey.
But try it. Give it a go. Cheers.